Hi everyone, this is Tuhin Banik from Thatware, and today we'll be discussing about 4x6, or in other words, not found pages. So before beginning, let us first discuss what actually is 4x6 errors. Now, I'm pretty much sure that being an SEO expert, you often might have encountered a problem such as 4x6. Now, 4 actually stands for not found protocol, which means that any particular web page in a website is not accessible to the users or the visitors for any given reasons. So let us explore the various type of 4x6 errors in this video today, and I'll also share you some short tips on how you can make sure that you avoid the 4x6 SEOs errors from your website thing. So without further ado, let us dive in. So basically there is 4 types of 4x6 errors. The first one is 400 error, the second one is 401, the third one is 403, and the fourth one, which is the most famous one, that is known as 404, or also known as 404 error. So now I'll be discussing all 4 of them one by one, and I'll also share some tips on how you can make sure that you have overcome that solution once you have encountered this type of problem. So let us start with the first one, which is known as 400 error, or also known as bad request error. So basically 400 or bad request error is an error which is provided by a server when a visitor or a website is trying to make a handshake with the browser or the server, and for some restrictions the server is unable to accept the user from accessing its server location. In that case, this error is known as a bad request error or a 400 error. And the possible solution is one can look into the access log file from one's hosting or the server, and based on the access log error code, this can be resolved from your immediate developer. So let me tell you that this is one particular instances where you might require the aid of a development team, because this can get too technical. The second error, known as 401 or unauthorized error. So basically whenever you are trying to log into a particular web page using any credentials and you have somehow put in an incorrect credentials, or the credentials are technically not correct, in that case you would encounter a 401 or an unauthorized error, which definitely means by its name that you are unauthorized from accessing the web page. In short, whenever certain URL or a web page is protected with ID and password, and if people do not have the valid credentials, then a 401 error can trigger. Or the possible solution is simple, you just need to enter the correct credentials, and that's all. The third error is 403, or also known as forbidden error. So basically, as the name suggests, this error can be triggered whenever a particular landing page is forbidden from getting a request accepted from the client server or from the user. In other words, suppose you are trying to visit a website, example.com, and for some reason they have blocked any of your like IP or maybe location. In that case, you would be shown a 403 error, which is known as a forbidden error. The fourth error is known as 404 error, which is not found. And for SEO experts like us, this is one of the most common 404 error which one can come across. So basically 404 are pages not found, which means that if you have any broken link on your website, or maybe if you have any kind of pages which are broken, pages which does not exist, and if user try to search them or land on that particular page, then 404 or not found error can be triggered. Now the thing is, this is something which can really harm the SEO. Now let us understand why 404 error can cause a harm in the SEO. So as a matter of fact, 404 error stands for not found, and whenever a 404 error is encountered, Google's database would have a stack that particular website might be having something which can cause a result in a wrong user experience, because users like me and you can jump into a website and it can also provide some like unwanted pages or pages which even does not exist, and this might result in negative user experience, and anything that causes a negative user experience can trigger Google on negative SEO. So in short, this is one of the most powerful 4x6 error that needs to be redefined and fixed in order to prevent your SEO value from getting drained. So I'll share you three ways by which you can prevent 4xx errors from happening. The first reason is you can always check your server access or server access log to make sure you do not encounter any kind of unauthorized access or forbidden errors. So this is first part by which this can be prevented. The second way is if you have broken pages on your website, you can scan your website with tools like SEMrush, Screaming Frog, and any other tools available on the marketplaces, and you can get a collection of the pages that are 404 or where the pages does not exist, and then you can use a 301 redirection or 302 redirection depending upon your use case, and you can use that to rectify the 404 error. And the last but not the least, you can always create a 404 landing page designed for the users, which can have some sitemap that can redirect the users to their navigated pages. So these three are the main methods by which you can prevent the 4xx errors, and also these methods will make sure that your site's SEO value would not drain away if you really encounter an 4xx error in the near future. So thanks for watching. Hope to see you soon in the next video. Thank you.